grade year. So that was in 2014. Five. 14. I'm not that old.
I was in
2014.
2004. No, not 2014. 2004. You're right, I am that old. Oh my god.
Sounds like
oh my god.
2013.
How long have you been? Nice, rocking it out. That is the precursor to the bassoon, and was made in the 16th century.
Ocean.
Yes. They didn't actually start calling it a bassoon until the 17th century, so the 1800s. Though it's a great idea, it is not the same as something else. Okay. You have a humidifier that's going to be the same, or does it change? Yes. Yeah. You can also use orange peel.
Yeah.
One of Dr. favorite things. I use it. Are you going to have to do it? Or should I have to do it? Or should I have to do it?
sounds very fun. Yeah, I've been trying to.
Yeah, how's that little default though? Is it so good with it?
Sometimes on a good day. It's just like playing it really fast because I'm not used to the way that it's a lot of the work, so.
Well, the only way to get comfortable with it is to play it. So, we're gonna do I do, you do. So, I'm starting on E flat and I'm going up to E flat and D scale. That's why I.
Okay.
Maybe. Okie dokie. So I was going to have everybody talk for a minute. I guess that includes us today.
Sweet.
That's fun. All right. Who would like to start? Shane. Oh, wonderful. Can you read that first paragraph?
Middle-aged predecessor of the bassoon, part of the Shawn family, and was called the Bombard. The Bombard was a cylindrical tube with seven holes in the double. This instrument was particularly common in the Middle East.
Yes, it was also very common in Europe, I think.
Oh,
it does look like an oboe, doesn't it? Isn't that, it looks like a recorder, oboe, clarinet. Look at how wide the bottom of the bells are. And each of those different ones, they're all bombarding, I don't necessarily know. But they are all pitched in a different key. Right? So instruments back then couldn't play in all keys. Yeah. So that D could only play in the key of D, the one on the very far right hand. And the one next to it could only play in the key of C, and the one next to it could only play in D flat.
Well, that'd be actually kind of helpful if you just put the songs,
if there wasn't any key change, yeah, but, and like, back then in the Middle Ages, it wasn't common to see key changes, so there was no problem with it.
And then they played for, like, kings, so, like, everyone had, like, a
key. Yeah, they played for kings, they played for, the fourth one, and the two, three, four, oh, goodness. I think it is the D-flat.
I think it's C,
D-flat. No, the C is the second one from in on the right.
So I think it's best.
There's G, D-flat, something. I think it's D-flat.
I thought it was the other one.
Hold on, here. You know what? I have it. It's probably, it's on here. It's much more easy to see on here. Let me see. Oh my gosh, open up! Anyways. Do it. Okay. No, if I still can see it. I don't know. Sorry. So that's them in color, if you want to see them in color. Yep. And then, I guess I'll take the second paragraph. Instrument makers of the 16th century continued to make bombards that would reach lower and lower notes to meet the demands of music. But eventually, the instrument was reaching 3 meters long and becoming physically difficult to manage. The solution was to fold the tubing in half like many brass instruments had done before. This new instrument was called the bassoon, or bassoon, if you know about it. I'm not sure.
And I have a little recording of how the bassoon sounds. And here's it in color if you want to see it in color. Right? It's kind of neat. My speakers aren't that loud though, so.
It was built in various sizes, all the way from a small soprano down to a contrabass that stands about 6'4", and yet it was the bass instrument that was most utilized and probably most functional of all the dulcians in the Renaissance period.
I've always loved calligraphy.
Alrighty. I like that. Yes, I have played calligraphy. I played calligraphy quite often, actually. It's kind of how I got into college.
Really?
Yeah, because I applied for Allstate Orchestra, and I got first alternate. And then they called me back, and they're like, well, we need a contribution player, so if you can find a contribution, you can play in Allstate. And the only contribution I could find was Hooters contribution. And I came and I took a lesson with Dr. Levy, and he, like, forced me into applying to CSU, and then I ended up here. So
nice.
That's how that works. And then, last page, last paragraph.
The first instrument, truly called a bassoon, was built in the 17th century, and it lacked chromaticism, and it was missing two different pieces. Since then, many improvements have been made, giving us the modern day.
Well, the picture is on the left. One of them is a dolphin, and then the other two are modern bassoons. What do you notice about them?
They start to get more.
Yes.
They get taller and more refined.
Yep.
They also.
They have more pieces, don't they? They have more pieces, they have more holes, they have more keys, they're taller. And then on the end here is just kind of like a little progression of, you know, from like Sean to Bombard to Belgium to Bassoon. There are French bassoons in here and there are German bassoons. They're different. If you're ever playing a French bassoon, it's not played the same way as a German bassoon. Like, it's very similar, but they have different key systems. And then the very end is a contra bassoon. So yeah, and actually, maybe one day I can bring the contra down. We definitely have a contra bassoon. That's a good story on the whole. Now, let's take out self and self again.
Wait, you said French bassoon was different than
German bassoon. Mm-hmm.
You know,
I've never heard of French bassoon, and I don't really. I know that.
So, the most like, common ones are
German. Yeah. More common ones are definitely German bassoon. And, French bassoons are, like, built to play higher. Like, it's much easier to get out, like, a super high E flat on a French bassoon than it would be on a German bassoon. So, if you're playing a French piece of music, like, it's likely that, like, it's got ridiculously high notes in it. And you're like, oh my gosh, what do I do with this?
Yeah.
Okay. Self and self again. Can we look at C? Ooh.
When people are sad, you can't.
Some people are used to 35, but...
Yeah.
Okay. Specific to my bassoon.
Yeah, for my F
actually. Mm-hmm. It doesn't just be more. Okay. I would like us, our goal is to play the staccato notes staccato and also play my fortepiano and also make sure we give full value to those quarter note reps.
But at least we don't.
So what are our goals, Shane?
To play staccato, to stay in mezzo forte,
whatever you want to say.
And then give full attention to those beautiful, beautiful patterns. Okay. You said quarter rest.
Good job!
Oh, right!
It's okay, it's a long day. We're doing it. Okay, so can we... This is 2-2, 90 beats per minute, so... So everybody conduct in 3-2. One, two, three, four, five. hearing 2-2, what is the quarter note going to feel like? Yeah. Now conduct the 8th note in 4-4. Now, can we go like that, like that? So it's going to go down, in, out, up, down, in, out, up, down, in, out, up. There you go. Cool. So now can we conduct in 4 and sing our parts, starting at where we play C? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Well, that was my bad. I entered early. D before D. I moved 2 or something like that. I went to
Okay. Now we're going to conduct in 2-2. I'm going to sing it again. It's not in 6-8.
I know.
Those are two very different time signatures.
Okay.
So.
Uh-huh.
Show me where you have melody 1 and melody 2 from 92 to the end, and then check it with my center.
92.
Couldn't you mark in find melody 1 on your lead sheet?
Oh yeah.
You see that melody anywhere?
Oh yeah, yeah.
Right. Tell them that you're watching how to make it.
Okay, so for like 97, I find letter.
Which melody is it? What is 94? Is that a melody? Melody 1 is, we know what melody 2 is.
Oh yeah, and melody 95 is melody 1.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so now we are going to roll a finger from 92 to the end. Do you think you can do it? I think you can do it. We're only going 90. That's
22 clicks lower than what it's supposed to be. First, we use this little eighth note for it. Triple it. Eighth note. Pick one answer, stay with it. Be confident about it. I want to know that you know. I don't want you to just guess and me to tell you the right answer.
Oh, it comes after. Right?
No.
Yeah.
It comes before. So,
is it?
You remember when we talked about what the dot does? Yes. About how much? Half of the note. So, but is that a compliment? What is that?
An eighth note.
So, it's a 16th note longer. So, how many 16th notes are inside that? How many 16th notes are inside a dotted 8th note?
Three.
Yes, three. So, is 3 16th notes less or more than 1 quarter note? Or 1 beat? But you're staying with us. You're left. Cool. So do you understand where it comes in before beat two? Can you explain it to me? Okay. Cool. Let's circle 98 to the end again. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Now
99 again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's try and play it. Yeah, you get to play online with him. Oh, perfect. I think some of your problem might be that your bassoon is like not a super great bassoon. It's gonna feel different.
Uh-huh.
finger 92. 1, 2, squeeze the one finger. 1, 2, 3. How do you feel like you're getting really successful?
Yes.
You feel like you can tie it?
Yes.
Okay, that's good. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, again. It's okay, do it one more time. I'm in the center. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Now, let's take it up to 84.
1, 2, 3.
Nope. 1,
Put it all together. One. Almost. Yeah, I think that might actually be part of what's going on with your low notes. I think when you play your low notes, you move your top fingers and then you're not like creating a seal. Because it sounds like you're just sitting sleeping and you can't face me. Sorry, I know this is awkward. We only have like 5 minutes, but I really want to like make your life easier.
I
just
really
You're so close, like, I feel bad that you feel like you're not as good as me, because you really are. You just, like, are having wonderful things. Sarah, will you play? Like this. Like that. Can you give a 3-3 spot like that? No. It's not right. Because when you play your D-flat, what you're doing is you're reaching your soul. And if those holes aren't covered, your low notes are not going to come up. Does that make sense? Here, so try and do it a couple times. So you see the D-flat. Well, we gotta go to full ensemble.